You may have seen something on the internet that all humans are identical 99.9% of the time. What does this mean, and is it true? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is an episode of a segment of DNA. Today, I want to talk about how similar all of us really are. Now, there's some different statistics out there that you may read, but what it boils down to is that humans are somewhere around 99.5 to 99.9% the same. In other words, every single person on Earth is so identical to you that there's really very few differences that we have. Now, what does this mean, and can this really be true? Well, when you start to look in biology, most of the processes of life are the same. So not only are humans 99.9% the same, but we're about 98% the same as chimpanzees. And even something as dissimilar from us as rice, the plant, we still share about 25-30% of our DNA with rice. Now, that doesn't mean we're rice. It just means that we share that DNA with rice, because a lot of the processes of life are the same, whether you're human or whether you're rice. So let's get in and figure out how humans are 99.9% the same. What does that mean? Well, our DNA is 3 billion, that's billion with a B, 3 billion letters long, and that codes for everything in our human existence. Now, 99.5% to 99.9% of all of those letters in that DNA are identical for everyone. All humans who live now, all humans who have ever lived. Now, the DNA is divided up into genes, and each gene is divided up into little segments that happen in three-letter increments. And I'm not going to get into the details of what each of those different three-letter increments are or how they develop, but just think of that we have to have three letters together in order to do something. So when we say that we're 99.9% the same, what happens when we start to change some of those letters? Well, changes in those letters can really have four different effects. The first one is that no change actually happens. So you can change a letter in certain instances and it doesn't affect anything. All of your processes, all of what it codes for is still the exact same. And that's just because of some simple chemistry and how that DNA works. So one thing that can happen is nothing. That's great. Nothing happens. The second thing that can happen is that change can be meaningful, but DNA also has an ability to repair itself. And so that change may get repaired. And so you're back to your original bit of DNA. Now, the next thing is that that change could have some benefit. It could be neutral. Maybe it just affects the color of your eyes or the color of your hair. Or it might be harmful, but not too harmful. So it's something that still allows you to grow up, to reproduce, and to pass that change on to somebody else. And finally, the last type of change is one that is really fatal. It's something that is going to kill the cell or kill the entire organism. And in a lot of cases, this happens inside the womb before you even get to full gestation. So all those changes are what make humans different. Most of those are the ones that are not harmful, they're just really neutral. Well, let me give you an example then of how we're still 99.9% the same. Now, remember I said that the DNA segments in genes, they happen in three-letter increments. And so if we change one of those three letters, that's when something bad or something good can happen. So let's use the example of our blood type to show how we are 99.9% identical. Most people know what their blood type is, whether it's A, B, AB, or O. And that blood type is coded for on a gene on chromosome number 9. That gene is 1,062 letters long. And if you have all the normal sequence of that, then you're going to be blood type A. If, however, at position 261 on that 1,062 sequence, you have a deletion. One of those letters gets deleted there at position 261. It actually changes it to code for blood type O. So you only have one letter difference between A and O. And if you do the math, 1,061 divided by 1,062 is 99.9%. So what about blood type B? Well, when you start to look at the sequence of those that are blood type B with those that are blood type A, there are four places that they are different that affect that. Four changes, that's it. So if we take 1,058 and divide it by 1,062, you get 99.6%. It is still within that 99.5 to 99.9% range. So no matter what your blood type is, at least 99.6% of the entire sequence of it is the same as everybody else, whether they're A, whether they're O, or whether they're B. But that small change, whether it's the one letter for O or whether it's the four letters for B, can make all the difference whenever you're having a blood transfusion or whenever you're giving blood. And so even though it's a small difference, it can have vastly different effects on us. So we're still 99.9% the same, but that 0.1% really makes each of us unique. If you have any questions about how you might be different from other people with your genetics, ask it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it for you. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so that it can reach more viewers. Don't forget to subscribe so that you won't miss another episode of Family History Fanatics.